Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to another video of Triple Grace. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And the topic of this video is the Nines of Arf, the onslaught on the temple. Brothers and sisters, there are many, many videos outside on YouTube talking about the Nines of Arf and what happened there. So many things that happened during the history at the time of the Nines of Arf, including the destruction of the two temples exactly on that day. Now, when we look at it, and we have now this broad understanding, we have this understanding of great revelations about three-time events, about patterns that must be fulfilled from the past to the present to the future. We have all this understanding. Then what does the Nines of Arf this year, 2021, it will not by no coincidence fall on the 18th of July, this Sunday, mean for us? If there is an onslaught on the temple, if there is a destruction coming for the temple, what temple is here referred to? We know that there is no temple physically built in Jerusalem right now. So is this what we will see and experience from this day forward, from the 18th July forward? Will that be fitting in our timeline, in what the Lord has shown us so many revelations about looping, about the new matrix, about new Egypt, about the Pharaoh coming up, about the returning to the time of Mr. O, and then later on Mr. T? Is that all coming together and starting in this time frame with 40 days of Jesus here on earth, then Pentecostal outpouring in a certain way for the Leah brides, and then the start of the seals at the Feast of Trumpets? Brothers and sisters, I believe that is all being set in motion now from the Nines of Arf. The attack on the temple is, what temple do we speak about? We talked about that before, that during the seal tribulation, we are the temple. We are the movable temple with skin covered that is being going through the wilderness towards the holy mountain, towards Mount Zion, as a pattern to the first Exodus. This will be now a much greater Exodus coming up. And so we will be that temple. And there will be an onslaught on this temple from Satan. The enemy is preparing to take the people in the snare. He is preparing to trap them right now. He is preparing to let his son run in full power, and then the people will be looped back into time. They will enter a new matrix of deceit and illusion. Most likely, with his toxin, he has prepared most of the bodies already to accept this without any resistance. The Nines of Arf will begin the onslaught of the temple, and that can only mean one thing for us: armor up and stand ready, because your destiny has come. The moment when Satan will move to try to go into the temple and possess that temple, in which way soever, either through mind manipulation, through time looping, through the poison that he has put already in, to activate something there. As soon as he's doing that, we know that our destiny will also begin. And our destiny will be to set the captives free, because they will go in a kind of prison. Not all in one place of a prison. Of course, we know that the harvest is worldwide and that we are also stationed worldwide in different places. I know. Nonetheless, all of these places will have been one new Zion that will come together. The Nines of Arf is the onslaught of the temple. Is it at this time that he pushed the button and now everything what is in the bodies of the people will be activated? Is a portal opening? Is he moving forward now and or backwards into the future past? No matter what will happen from this day forward, stand ready. That's the reason why I'm calling you to the two holy weekends. Be as close as possible to the kingdom, out of the world, out of Babylon, and out of the churches. Do not focus on anything else than your destiny and the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This is the time to stand in unity in the upper room. As the apostle had to wait for their outpouring, you also wait now for the portal to open. This is a time when you have to hold your white token very dearly in your hands and wait for the transport. The Knights of Arms will begin the onslaught of the temple. How it will come forth, only Satan knows his agenda and the Father. I am not briefed yet about that, but we will see it. But immediately when it begins, then also our destiny will start. So you need to stand ready. The 9th of Av is the 18th of July 2021. That is next Sunday. Brothers and sisters, we are so close. A few days away and everything will begin. The temple that we represent now is the temple of the wilderness. A movable temple. A temple covered with skin, as it was the tabernacles of old with Moses. And are we not back into a Moses spirit time of an Exodus? Yes, of course. Are we not back to the time when the Father has chosen a certain people to be in contact with him, as it was during the time of Exodus with Moses himself, who had always the contact to the Father? Then the Father selected the priests around Aaron's group to become the one that serve him as never before? Of course, all this is repeated right now through us, through our destiny, through what we were called for. The enemy is preparing the onslaught on the temple. That also means our temple has to become stronger and more holy, more pure, and we have to go into our new place from where we can operate. Does it mean we will all be together in the same place? No. Mount Zion is the connection of all the harvest, not Mount Zion, sorry, New Zion is the connection of all the harvest worker together in one mind for the kingdom of God. A bond that is so strong that you can call on the earth wonders and miracles, that you will be in contact with the Father instantly, an open heaven. And that is a contrast to the matrix of the enemy, a fake world that he is creating now, a new Egypt with a new Pharaoh, Mr. O, where a new world order is established, a totally illusional state, deception all over the place, and then also the fake aliens are coming in. All of this will come to pass. And in stark contrast to this stands then New Zion, the group of people that have also their own connection, one mind, one accord. All this connected through heavenly realms. The new Zion place. Blessings, resources, everything provided by the heavens for your harvest work. As long as you stay on the path to New Zion and to Mount Zion. And as long as you go and fulfill your destiny to be then guided into the new places. How that will be done? Teleportation or just around your area where you are stationed, the Lord will tell us. Do not worry about that. The time will come when you will fulfill your destiny and run your last race. And then at the end of it, at Mount Zion, you will be raptured into paradise with the harvest, with the offerings that you will bring there. The 9th of Av is a turning point for the whole world. Sunday. A holy weekend is lying ahead of us. Stay close. Stay ready to be lifted up any moment. The enemy is also preparing to use this weekend to start the onslaught on the temple. Will he push a button? Will he power up CERN or overload it so that all will take place? We will see. But this is the time when the temples were falling. And so this worldly temple, the temple that is not rooted on the rock, that is built on sand, the temple that is built in everything else than the kingdom of God, will fall on that day. And the enemy has prepared the bodies to receive his message. He has prepared the world through media, through poison, through everything what he has done, to prepare the world to receive now his onslaught. And through this onslaught, through this destruction of the temple, he will take them into his hands to make himself a god over this small, lost little g-gods in this world. The ninth of Av is the beginning of it. I expect really something to see and to start on that day. Pray over it, take it to the Lord, but stand ready, armor up right now. Whenever you have some loose ends, bring them together before that weekend. Put your backs together, stand ready. Anything can happen over the next two holy weekends. I love you all so dearly, brothers and sisters, and I hope this sheds some light on it, what it will be happen on the 9th of Av, that we are the movable living temple with skin cover. As it was the temple of the wilderness, the tabernacle of Moses, the great Exodus has come. And we will take the people out again from Egypt towards the holy mountain, towards Mount Zion. The Lord's fulfillment of the end times, his masterpiece, will begin. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that I will see you all on the other side. Be blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.